What's going on, fragrance lovers? Yeah, another review, another beauty. This house, I have sniffed, I'm gonna say 99% of their fragrances. There's only like a couple that I haven't sniffed. And that doesn't include the new ones that are coming out. More on that at a later date. But I don't seriously think, I've never sniffed a bad fragrance from this house, ever. Every single one of them has been home runs out of the park, you know, just phenomenal. This one's no different. This beauty right here, boom. I think you're gonna like this one. Well, let's just jump right into it, huh? Come with me on a fragrant journey in 3, 2. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Gold Prestigium is the name of this beauty out of the house of Mancera. And I'm going to tell you something right now. Again, Mancera, I've not sniffed any bad fragrances from this house, period. And I think, again, there's only like two of them that I have not sniffed. Let me go ahead and tell you guys what's happening with this one. But before I do, I'm going to jump into the notes as I customarily do. You know what it is. Stand by. And there you have it. So let's go ahead and jump into what this does when I spray it on my skin. Immediately, I am blasted with spicy citruses. That is it. That is all. Right out of the spigot, when that gate opens up and this thing is let loose, spicy citruses is what you're going to get. Now, where the tears are concerned, oud is listed as a top note. Not only do I not get any oud in the top notes, but I'm going to tell you right now, the oud in this is so light that it damn near takes an expert nose to pick it up, okay? You can get into arguments about synthesis and all that crap. I don't care about it. What I can tell you is you will get oud in this, but it's not going to be until deep, deep, deep into this fragrance that's dried down, if you get it at all. It's very light. So oud haters, take note. You're still going to love this. If you like citruses, spicy citruses, okay? Now, after about a half hour, maybe 45 minutes, you're going to start to get florals. Now, there are 3 florals in this fragrance, okay? Guys, I know what you're thinking. Florals equal feminine. Stop it. Throw that out the window. Not going to happen, right? About 45 minutes into this fragrance, you're going to start getting the florals. And they're going to be of the rose, orange blossom, and jasmine varieties. Now, the spiciness in this fragrance fades slightly, but it will not leave for good. All right? It sticks around until this fragrance dies. So you're going to get spicy citrus throughout this fragrance's tenure on your skin. When the florals kick in, it's just going to make it a little bit sweeter, a little bit softer. Now, what's going to offset the florals in this fragrance is a deep, earthy patchouli. Alright? That's going to give it that hippie edge. But not super hippie. Alright? Just like a lightweight hippie. A little bit grungy. But not too tough to take. Believe me. It is a really nice fragrance. Now, once that patchouli note kicks in, that's going to be a beautiful segue into the leather and the woods, as well as the sweetness. This fragrance does not open up sweet. Like I said, it opens up spicy, and then you're going to get florals. Round it out with, you know, a light hippie style patchouli. But not your Aunt Martha's, you know, 1972 patchouli. Nothing like that. It's not that skanky. So, once that starts to fade, you're going to be probably in the 3-hour mark. And that's when the leather and the wood start to kick in. We have talked about femininity and all of that stuff friggin' ad nauseum. I'm tired of talking about it. You know, I will answer questions because, you know, that's what I do. I love my subscribers. You guys are awesome. I like when you, you know, pepper me with questions. I'll answer them. And I realize as well that there are a lot of new jacks just coming into the game. And they don't understand the whole femininity, masculinity thing. And that it's all bullshit, as Master Ken would say. Alright. So the sweetness in this fragrance is... it's not really hardcore, but it's not very light either. Y'all gonna know it's a really sweet fragrance. The woods in this, like I said, will offset the sweetness a little bit, as well the leather. But everything about this fragrance is soft. There is nothing really like wicked, wicked hardcore about this fragrance. It's not gonna like sting your nose. It doesn't have any teeth. You know what I mean? But it's gonna be a really nice, I mean, just beautiful, sexy, soft neck nebula type of fragrance, as my man Roger Real Deep Cool would say. Again, the oud in here, although if you look on Mancera's site, it is listed as a top note. Hell no. Again, you're going to be hard pressed to detect it, but you will be able to. It's going to go hand in hand, I think, with the leather and the woods, and to a lesser extent the vanilla. But by the time the vanilla kicks in, you know, all the other, you know, notes above are going to be very, very much in the background. You're still going to detect them, but they're not going to be anywhere near as loud as the sweetness in this fragrance. So, at the end of it, what you're going to have is a sweet, spicy fragrance with, you know, a tiny bit of florals. This fragrance is unlike the other Mancera's in that the top and mid notes do not really play peekaboo like the other ones do. They don't come in, leave, come in and leave. They're not in and out like, you know, a kid, you know, playing on the back porch or whatever, coming in for like lemonade and going to take a piss. No. Nothing like that. When the top and middle notes fade, they fade good. Like real good. All right. They're hiding. You know, if it was a game of hide and seek, you're going to have to look really hard to find them. All right. They're there. But again, to the untrained nose, at the end of this fragrance, the only thing you're getting is very light woods and very light, soft suede. That's it. That's all you got. But in terms of the smell, it's, I mean, just phenomenal. Phenomenal fragrance. If you don't like a very loud, in-your-face type of fragrance, this is it right here. All right? It's not going to be in your face. It's not going to be punching you out or anything like that. But you will be noticed. All right? No question about that. Longevity, we're talking 12 hours. All right? You know, your scent bubble is going to be about, you know, 3 to 4 feet off your skin. Every hour after that, it starts to dissipate, get closer to the skin. Then when you get around, I'd say, you know, the 8-hour mark, it's going to be strictly a skin scent, but a nice, nice skin scent. Again, if you like beasting, stop the tape. This is not a beast of a fragrance. However, obviously, if you spray more, it's going to be louder, but it's not a beast, but it doesn't have to be. The scent is beautiful. This is the type of fragrance you wear when you go out on a date with a woman who doesn't, or a man for that matter, who doesn't really like loud in your face, you know, sting your nose, bite your ass, punch you in the face, and knock you the frig down fragrances. This is the type of fragrance that is, like I said before, is basically a neck nibbler, and you want to get close and comfortable with a really beautiful smell, but not enough so that you can smell them from a half a mile away. That's not this fragrance at all. So if that's what you're looking for, then this ain't the fragrance for you. But again, if you like that nice, soft, intimate, cozy type of fragrance, oh God, it is just flipping beautiful. You're going to love it, I think. And that's basically it. I know, it's a shorty, but what can I tell you? Really not a lot you can say. It is what it is. From the House of Mancera, a sexy ass, soft, intimate fragrance, and that is Gold Prestigium. I'm really digging this house. They're killing it every single release. And that's my review. My next one is soon. You guys have a great one. I'll talk to you later.